E ngā mana I ngā reo, I ngā karangatanga maha, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Thank you for the invitation to again take part in this annual hui about the important work of building our regions and planning the future of infrastructure here in New Zealand. I'm sorry I'm not able to be there in person, and I want to acknowledge Chief Executive John Ray, Chair Andrew Stevens, and Infrastructure New Zealand staff for putting together the program for this symposium. I'd also like to acknowledge Sarah Lang for her work with the Women's Infrastructure Network, including her nomination last year for New Zealander of the Year Award. There's some large changes underway in which you, as leaders of your industry, will play an important role. These include the RMA reforms, the government's urban growth and housing agendas, and a move to a more resilient and responsive infrastructure for greener growth and development. Today, I'd like to focus on how the Three Waters Reform Program will make our Three Waters services economically and environmentally safe and sustainable, and support our aspiration to deliver a world-class Three Waters system for all New Zealanders, no matter where they live. Water is integral to the natural and built environments that New Zealanders call home. A holistic, integrated view of this precious resource is important to me, and as Minister, I have approached water reform in that light. It's clear that rather than piecemeal solutions, we need comprehensive, system-wide reform to achieve lasting benefits for our communities. The reforms will continue to require significant engagement between central government, local government, iwi and industry professionals like yourselves. This reform program has three main pau or pillars. Pau Tuatahi, our Water Services Bill. Our first pau has been to comprehensively reform the drinking water regulatory framework, combined with targeted improvements to wastewater and stormwater regulation. The Water Services Bill, which I introduced to the House in July, aims to ensure New Zealand's drinking water is consistent with international best practice while improving oversight and transparency of waste and stormwater networks. In keeping with our intent to approach water reform through a holistic lens, the Water Services Bill requires all persons to have functions or duties under this legislation to give effect to te mana o te wai. Importantly, this will require councils to engage with tangata whenua in areas such as source water protection or water management decisions. I'm working to ensure this bill receives its first reading quickly when Parliament resumes, with the intention of referring the bill to Select Committee before Christmas. I encourage you to take the opportunity to have your say on the bill when it progresses to the Select Committee stage. Pau Tuarua, Taumata Arowai. The second pau of our water reform agenda has been to create a new dedicated water services regulator called Taumata Arowai to monitor and enforce the entire drinking water system. I understand you will shortly hear more from Bill Bayfield, Establishment Chief Executive of Taumata Arowai, about his organisation's role. I expect Taumata Arowai to be a real world modern regulator that ensures New Zealanders receive safe, acceptable drinking water and helps prevent adverse events from occurring, such as the Havelock North outbreak that resulted in the tragic loss of life. Regional councils will remain the primary regulators of storm and wastewater. However, given the interconnected nature of drinking water, wastewater and stormwater, Taumata Arowai will have an oversight role to promote better transparency and understanding of how these networks are performing. In carrying out this remit, Taumata Arowai will be guided by a Māori advisory group. This will assist the regulator on Māori interests and knowledge and how to give effect to te mana o te wai, mātauranga Māori, and ensure tikanga Māori is exercised. Pau Tuatoru, Service Delivery Reform. The third pau of our Three Waters mahi is reforming arrangements for the delivery of Three Waters services to our communities. We're faced with a Three Waters system that is under pressure across New Zealand, suffering from historic underinvestment, ageing infrastructure, and all too common failure. This situation is compounded by increasing capital costs, the need to build resilience to climate change and natural hazards, and increasing community expectations for the quality and performance of water services. Current arrangements, particularly for smaller councils, are not well suited to meet these big challenges. Fundamental change is required to deliver long-term, enduring solutions. COVID-19 has now posed more immediate challenges. That is why in July this year, the Prime Minister announced a funding package of $761 million to local government to provide immediate post-COVID-19 stimulus to maintain and improve Three Waters infrastructure and to support reform of Three Waters service delivery arrangements. I understand that there is good progress towards getting these funds out the door and the associated projects underway. For the wider reform package, we've committed to partnering with local government, alongside iwi as our treaty partners, to look into the establishment of larger multi-regional water providers across the country. These entities would ultimately deliver more affordable, efficient, reliable, and resilient water services, while significantly improving the safety and quality of drinking water and the performance of the waste and stormwater systems. You'll shortly hear from Tony Kelly, the Director of Tas Water, about the reforms that Tasmania has undertaken in their water sector. This is just one of the international examples that we're looking at to inform our own reforms here in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Our reforms represent a significant but necessary lifting of standards and requirements to make our drinking water safer and will provide a stable pipeline of work, delivering infrastructure upgrades and stimulating local economies. Our focus over the last few months has been on working with local government as our partners in this major reform program and iwi Māori as our treaty partners. I'm really aware that you, as key figures in the infrastructure sector, may not have had great visibility of what our work program is and where we're up to. I've asked my officials to set up several engagements with you before Christmas. This is our chance to achieve a lasting transformation, and we must ensure that we take our communities that we serve along with us. Let's together build a world-class water system that delivers lasting benefits for the people of Aotearoa, New Zealand. I wish you all the very best for the rest of your symposium. Nō reira, kei ngā iti, kei ngā rahi e whakamahi ana ngā mahi mō a tātou nei wai. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou katoa.